In this video, we will show you how to complete an H-2A temporary employment certification, also referred to as a 9142A application. Start by navigating to the top right-hand corner of the FLAG homepage and click Sign In to log into FLAG. Note, you must submit an ETA-790-790A H-2A agricultural clearance order before submitting the ETA-9142A temporary employment certification. Under the new application tab, find the H-2A temporary employment certification card and click Create New. Along the left-hand side of the screen, you will see a form step room. The blue circle indicates which section you are in while filling out the form. The first section is called Preliminary Questions, where it asks you if you're submitting an emergency filing. If this is an emergency filing situation, click Yes. Otherwise, click No. Select the Job Order Lookup button to locate your submitted job order, ETA-790-790A. The table shown will have a list of your submitted job orders. You can also use the search bar or type in the job order case number. Click Submit. A notification box will appear that says changing field values from your 790A may impact processing of this application. Click Acknowledge. Click Continue. Several fields in your 9142A application will be pre-filled with their function from the job order that was selected. As you complete sections of the form, the icon next to the section name will be updated. Each form field displays a small question mark with a circle around it. This handy feature is called the tooltip. Tooltips provide detailed instructions of what to include in each field. Section A asks you the nature of the H-2A application. Complete each of the fields within the section. You'll notice that information from the linked job order will be pre-populated into the form. Field A4 is a conditional field. If you select Yes, a gray box will appear that requires you to upload a statement of temporary need. Click the blue hyperlink, Browse, to search for a document to upload. Once completed, click Continue. Section B asks for the employer information. Complete each of the fields within the section and click Continue. If you are part of a network, you have the ability to populate an employer profile. For more information on networks, review the network video. You can also select a profile from the drop-down and click Populate. Section C asks for the employer point of contact information. Review the information from the linked job order. Field C10 is a conditional field. Select the country from the drop-down list. Field C8 will appear in the light gray box. Select the state from the drop-down. Once all the fields have been completed, click Continue. Section D asks for the attorney or agent information. Select the type of representation. You can also select a profile from the drop-down and click Populate. If attorney is selected, complete fields D1 through D19. If agent is selected, complete fields D1 through D21. Click the blue hyperlink, Browse, to search for a document to upload. You will need to upload a copy of the current agreement or other documentation demonstrating the agent's authority to represent the employer certificate of registration and a copy of the agent's current Migrant and Seasonal Agricultural Worker Protections Act. Click Continue. Section E asks for job opportunity and supporting documentation. Field E6 requires you to upload a copy of fully executed work contracts with each fixed site agricultural business identified on the ETA-790A form. Click the blue hyperlink Browse to search for a document to upload. Field E7 is a conditional field. If yes is selected, upload a copy of the employer's current MSPA certificate of registration. If no is selected, a disclaimer will appear warning you that you will receive a notice of deficiency, NOD, for the application if you do not upload a copy of your MSPA certificate of registration. Field E8 requires you to upload a copy of a surety bond. Field E9 requires you to identify each fixed site agricultural business that will provide housing and/or transportation to workers. Once all the required fields have been completed, click Continue. Section F asks you to read the Declaration of Employer and Attorney Agent and agree to the terms. Click the blue hyperlink, Browse, to search for the signed Appendix A document to upload. Once completed, click Continue. Section G asks you for the preparer information. Complete this section if the preparer of this application is a person other than the one identified in either Section C, Employer Point of Contact, or Section D, Attorney or Agent of this application. Click Continue. The Application Documents section provides a summary of the documents you have provided while filling out the 9142A form. You will also have the option to upload additional documents here as well. Click Add Documents. Click the blue hyperlink Browse to search for a document to upload. Click Save. Select the document type. Click Continue. We are now at the last step of the application, the Review and Submit section. The form stepper on the left-hand side of the screen will show you what sections need to be revisited, as it may have incorrect or unfilled required fields. Once all the errors have been addressed, carefully review the information and click Submit. You will be directed to a page that says you have successfully submitted your H-2A Temporary Employment Certification application. A confirmation email with your case number will be sent to your email address. To return to flag, click Return to Dashboard.